it, cause it ain't no handouts to call me if you need me, cause I got fans now. Everybody against you as soon as you get up, but don't nobody be with you when the going get tough. Don't nobody be with you when the going get rough, and no matter what you give them, that shit is
Mama, KJ.
He basically
begged.
Oh my gosh, you're his
face. No problem. We are on the way to San Antonio, Texas.
You didn't say it right, Spike. It's San Antonio.
San Antonio.
San Antonio.
That's what I said.
You said San Antonio.
All right, don't mind that.
If you really understood.
They're not a part of the vlog. They messing up the vlog, but we are on the way to San Antonio, Texas. How do you say it?
I dropped my phone.
San Antonio.
San Antonio. San Antonio, but we already have a layover in Orlando, and then from Orlando to San Antonio, so I'll see y'all there. Okay. Right, we have landed in San Antonio. We're in the rental car right now, and then we're about to head to the hotel for check-in, so to get my measurements and stuff. So I'm going to go, I'm going to say 6'1 and a half, 10, 5 hand, 34 and a half arm, and 83 weight, but they might not let me record inside, but I'll record after I get my measurement. All right, so we're about to go to the All-American ceremony. So my dad is friends with one of the head coach of the West team. So he was able to get us tickets, so we get to see the jersey presentation for all the All-Americans. So this is a really big thing, a really exclusive thing, and I'm really blessed I get to watch it. Hopefully I ball out, and hopefully I can get my invite either now or if I have to go to Top Gun again. But so that was the award ceremony. The jerseys and stuff was tough. They got all the uniforms, but of course you've seen the pictures of me, but those dudes are huge. But of course you got my guy like Walt, he's the same height as me, but when it comes to like these All-American games, the top players in the country, they like them big. So I'll see y'all in a little bit once I get to the crib. We're staying at an Airbnb across from Alamo Dome, but I'll see y'all once I get there. All right. We're back at the Airbnb now. It's 10:39. Listen to a little bit of music right before I go to bed, but I don't got to be there until 9:45, so I'll probably wake up a little early. I got some oatmeal and then a protein ball I have in the morning. So yeah, just getting ready for this combine, trying to get a good night's sleep. Got some gospel music playing right now, but shit, I'll see y'all in the morning.
Hey, y'all.
Alright, it's about 9:13, 9:14, and we gotta be there at 9:45, so currently getting ready. I had some breakfast and stuff. I had like a protein ball and then some oatmeal. And so getting on my be rocking NC State and I think South Carolina. Yeah, I'm gonna be rocking that out. Got my braces, got my cleats. So we getting ready. So it's about time to get active.
Alright, so I'm gonna break it down. This is me. We're about to start warming up. So they kinda put us on these cones to start. But first thing I did was my vertical. So I walk over there, I'm like, man, I'm feeling like a hooper today. I'm feeling like a hooper. So I jumped 126 and I got a 27 inch vertical. So yes, this is me getting ready for the 40. I didn't run my fastest. I've bulked up a little bit. I'm at about 295, but my 10 yard split was 1.8, and my trainer's like, that's a little slow. So, but you see I'm moving. It looked like I'm moving though. You feel me? And of course, run through the line. Next, I had my broad jump, bro. Oh, no, my fault. I started stretching because I had to run two. The first one, it kind of hurt my hip flexor, so you see me stretching. But next is my broad jump. My broad, this one was clean. I got it. Bam. And I fall. That was perfect. So then he's like, all right, get up. You'll do another one. So I'm like, I bet. I get up. I'm feeling good. I kind of fall over a little bit. I fall, and then I'm like, okay. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Get ready. Bam. Not as far as the first one, but it was still smooth. And then here's 5.10.5. I'm telling you, the turf was terrible. You'll see in a second. The turf was terrible. Bam! Bam! And he looks at me, he's like, bro. Then I messed up again, but then he let me run one more. This one, I ran, I think, one of the fastest at the camp. Actually got posted on Twitter for it, but still not my fastest. I ran a 4.65 in February at 2.75.
All right, so this is what we start. This is bag drills. He had us do some weird drills that I've never done before. But, like, of course, we got drills like this. You know, used to be a linebacker back in the day, sixth grade, pick six against Farnsley. Never forget. Watch. Bend the hips. Explode back up. Drop your hips. Don't fall now. There was a kid who ran into a barricade doing this. It was kind of funny. This is cutoff drill. Usually, you just got to be able to tell and read. So that one, he flew. This one, I felt I could retake him over, so I kept running, dropped my feet, and started pushing him forward, getting him out. Now, this is the one thing I hate, is run game drills with no pads, because there's nothing for you to grab onto, right? So I think he tells me to go left and then block backside. It's kind of weird because you'll be working with your backside guard and he'll pick him up, but he tells you just seal him off backside. Usually you'll climb up, or this one, I take him out the play, drive him. You just create a cutback lane. This is a little weird. He taught us to, like, face your palms to your face and then punch and then shoot your head up to the sky. At camps, you've got to learn to just go with what the coach says. Here's some one-on-ones. This one, he got me right there. Remember, this is my first rep playing center since July of last year. So it's been a while. So just getting the hang of it. But once I get the hang of it, it's reps. Now it's just the snaps you see. Boom. Good feet, punch him out. Don't get past me. Can't get past me. This one, let me see what this one, how I did. Biggest thing really is just snaps. My feet work, drive him out the play. Bounce him out the club. I think I dump him this one. I gotta remember, but he did hit me in my face in one of these, and I got a little mad. Oh, let me see. And I just dropped them, kept it nice and simple. And then this next clip's best of the rest. It's in front of all the scouts. This got posted on Rivals. Under the radar.
Y'all just see my reps. Domination, that's all I know. Of course, work with my dad and the best trainer at NSP, Mikhail. I don't think my mama recorded my 40 times, but of course she got my one-on-ones. So you get to see how I work my feet and my... It's kind of harder when you're doing one-on-ones with no pads. You got nothing to grip on. So you got to be real quick with your feet. And then you'll see he hits me in my face the first up. I'm like, all right, bro. So I hit him with the set and then, dude. And then I'm going to be on under the radar. I'm gonna throw that clip in right here and shoot. Yeah. That's how I balled out. I hope y'all enjoy. You know, I got my South Carolina. I have my NC State gloves and my South Carolina gloves. So, shoot. I'll see y'all tomorrow for awards. We're going to go to the All-American game tomorrow. Support my boy, Walclair Flynn. But, shit, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Bam!
Well, we are now walking to the Alamo Dome to go watch the All-American game. I think it starts around, what time does the game start? It starts at 12. It is currently 11:22, so we'll be making it just in time. Big news, just got an offer from Miami. The U.
Alright, due to the fact that it's in a huge stadium, I've just kind of compiled the best clips of the game. I was just going to do a little voiceover, but you got your boy running for a huge, I think like 15 yards. But well, the biggest thing about the Adidas All-American game is just like how many people go. I think there was like 22,000 at this game. And shoot, here's some highlights. That's Jeremiah Smith, the number one player in 2024. Hit him for a blur. Hit him with a, hey man, to the crib. Another cool thing about this game is during the game, some players would get the commit. So they had even some 2025s get the commit during the game. Of course, only 2024s can play during it, but they brought in like the five-star 2025 players to go. Let's see what happens. Hit him on this little screenplay, ran hard. Of course, you can't hear, but he made a loud pop. He said, like a thud. I'm like, ooh, ooh. Second down, second and long. Let's see what it hit him with. Oh my gosh, that kid who just picked the ball is committed to Minnesota. Dog of an interception. And actually, of course, it's East versus West, but we were kind of going for West because three coaches from Kentucky got picked. Coach Hawkins, the head coach of Bryan Station. I think the receiver DB coach, Haskins. And then Marvin Danzer was the D-line coach, and he used to coach with my dad. So, ooh, hit him. Little double pass screen. Okay, then. Downfield blocking. Big game. Let's see what happens here. Drops back. Oh, takes off. My mama was talking about this. She doesn't think that he got in, but of course there isn't replay, so you really can't go against what they say. But big run to the crib. I'm pretty sure West ended up winning. They were up big, and then East started coming back and coming because East started off slow. Marquise Lightfoot played defensive end for Team West. I think he had maybe like two or three sacks, but he had a whole bunch of pressures and hurry. Straight dog. He's committed to Miami, so I might see him soon. See, my mama's reaction is like, ooh, I don't know if he got in. But, yeah. Let's see what's up next. Oh, this is them taking a knee, them kneeling it out. They got pretty turned after the game, so, I mean, shoot. I want an All-American game. Shoot, I'd be turned after, too. East versus West. But me, personally, if I'm East, I ain't losing. But that's just me, though. And then this is everybody on the field. So they let a cool thing that they let do. They let like all young aspiring fans come onto the field. Mama, there's KJ, little dreadhead. Shoot. But yeah. One big thing they tell the players is don't give away your jersey, your helmet, or your cleats, because those is like irreplaceable things, but like your sleeves and gloves, because most schools you won't even be able to wear that. There's my boy Walt and his family. But yeah, I'd say I love the experience down there. It was something real special. Shoot, here's another pan view of everybody. And then I see you got 13 minutes autograph zone. So people got their jerseys signed and stuff. It was real dope. But that's just the All-American game.
Currently, we're about to leave the house. I'd say this is a successful trip. So we got the Miami offer.
Alright, I forgot to record me a little outro, but this is me talking to Vanderbilt. We had a real good talk. He'll come see me soon, but of course I can't let y'all hear the audio because it's private, but I got a whole bunch of visits coming up. West Virginia next week, NC State on the 20th, Miami on the 27th, Louisville in Kentucky, so I got a whole bunch of content coming out. So I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe, and I'll see y'all at West Virginia next week. Woo!